Hello, so today I'm going to show you two very simple ways how to power on your HTC that doesn't turn on. So there are several reasons that it can happen, and what happens after is that it doesn't turn on and has a strange red LED here that lights on and off and doesn't power on the device. So my reason that it happened, and it's also the most common reason and it may happen to you too, is that the battery just overcharged. So you maybe just let it at night charging or something and then it just got overcharged. So if you knew Androids, you cannot overcharge them over around 6 hours. Only iPhones you can, because it stops charging after when it needs to, and Android it just continues charging even though it says like it's charged. So the second reason it could happen is from installing a ROM or a bootloader or something that doesn't have to do with this device, and you just try to install it. So for the second reason, this solution may not work. So now I'm going to show you how to fix it. So there are two very easy ways. So the first one, that's also the easiest one, is just buying a new battery. But the second one that needs maybe a little bit experience, or not really, you just have to have an LED at home and some crocodile cables like this ones. So in the back you see here minus and here plus. So you just have to put in the plus a cable and in the minus a cable, and then just connect it with the LED. So let's do it. So here I've done it. So you also would better do it with a red one or a green one or a different color, so that you would know what's plus and what's minus, so you wouldn't get confused. So here I put red as plus as typical, and as you see here there is a longer one and here is a shorter one. So the longer one is plus and the shorter one is minus, so you should just connect them like this and then the LED should turn on. If it didn't turn on, try to change it and it may work, but it also may burn the LED. If it doesn't work at all, maybe your LED is already burned, so just change another LED. So after that you should just leave it until the LED turns off. So it may take maybe 3 days or so until the LED turns really off, and after it turns completely off you should just put the battery back in the HTC and then just charge it until it will work. So if no LED works with your battery, be sure that's the same voltage as the battery. In my case it's 3.7 volts. So after being sure that's the same thing, if it still doesn't work, then the only thing that you can do is buy a new battery. If it does work like mine, you should just leave it in a place or something that it would finish. It may take something like 3 days or even sometimes more until the LED just turns off. After it turns off, all you should do is take off the battery of the LED and put it back in your HTC. Begin charging the HTC and then see if it powers on after a few minutes. After it's done and you see it doesn't work anymore at all, and you're sure it doesn't work anymore, then you can disconnect it and disconnect everything like that. And then after that, just take the battery and put it back in your HTC. If you did everything right, your phone should not do any sign, no red sign, nothing, like if it wouldn't work at all now. What you should do is just connect the power cable and just wait. So now you should see it charging. Now you should let your HTC charge until the light is off or is changed to green. So after the orange LED went on and off, now it's suddenly only on and it still charges. So you should just leave it like that until it powers off or gets green. Until it doesn't get green or turns off, you should not stop charging it or disconnect it with any way. So after waiting 30 minutes to 1 hour with the orange LED on, I think that's time to turn on the phone. So let's just click here, and here, as you see, it just turns on as fine. Let's wait to see if it turns on until the end. And yes, it really works, as you see here, works just fine. The HTC finally works, so wow, I'm really amazed. So the HTC here works just fine and it obviously opened, so now you have just to wait until it's complete charging. Next time, do not let it overnight charge or something, you'd better not do it with any Android phone. If you see that your phone has all kinds of problems loading widgets, I'd also recommend you restoring it. So to restore, all you should do is just go to settings. So here is settings, and then you should go to SD and phone storage. Other phones are a little different and maybe you have to find it in privacy or all kinds of stuff. Anyway, here's factory data reset, so this is the thing that you have to do. You can also erase your SD card, that's also recommended, and then reset phone and everything, and that's it. Now you only have to wait until it opens again, and then you have a completely new phone. Be sure that before deleting all your stuff, first save your stuff on a computer or something, and after you can put it back. And here, now we just wait until it resets. I'm also really happy that I made the video, because the whole solution I just found by myself. I didn't even look on the internet, I just thought all by myself, and I wasn't sure at all before making this video if it would work or not. So because of this, I would obviously appreciate if you can just like the video, comment down below any questions or something you want me to help you with, and I'm going to try to answer you as fast as I can, and also subscribe to see more of my videos.